Hey, this is Ben at Harrison. I'm the product manager for Mixbus, and today I'm going to demonstrate some of our export features. Mixbus can export multiple files and multiple formats all at once. We've got a really rich exporting function. Mixbus has multiple ways that you can initiate an export. For example, I can select a time range and then right-click on the time range and choose Export Range, and that will open the export window. I can also choose to make a time range and set my start and end points for the range. So this is going to set my session start and end. So you see the start and end markers appear. And now if I go to the main menu and choose Session Export to Audio Files, that will automatically know to use the session start and end point as the time span. I can also choose to select a specific region and right-click on the region and navigate to the export menu item. That opens the same export dialog with all my options, but it gives me an additional source tab. And the source tab allows me to export either the region contents without the fades, the region contents with the fades, or the track output. The track output includes all of my Mixbus processing, like the EQ and the compressor, as well as all of my plugins. The cool thing about a region export is that it's nearly instantaneous because it doesn't process any of the other tracks, only the region and track that you've selected. I can also open the export dialog directly from the menu, and there are some additional options in addition to exporting the whole session. I can also export stems. In this case, I get an additional channels tab, and under channels, I can choose which of the individual tracks or mix buses that I would like to export, and I can choose to apply the track processing or not. And each of the checked boxes will result in a separate WAV file. So each of my mix buses are stereo files, and each of my individual tracks can be exported, and each of these tracks will generate its own separate file. This is really useful for exporting your tracks as stems for someone else to import into another workstation or to share your sessions with somebody who doesn't have all of your plugins. If I choose Export to Audio Files from the main menu, then by default it's going to export the session from start to end, and it's going to export the master bus output. So if I click the Channels tab, you'll see that by default it's chosen the master bus, a stereo output, two channels, and it's sending output one from the master into the first channel of the file and output two of the master to the second channel of the file. Now we can switch to export a mono file. So if I've changed the channels to one, I now only have one output, and I can choose which of the two outputs from the master bus will go into that file. The most common operation is to initiate an export by clicking Export Session to Audio File. And when I do that, Mixbus will automatically select the session time span from start to end, and it will automatically select my master bus as the export source, and it will default to a two-channel output file with the first channel fed from the output number one of the master bus and the second channel fed from output number two of the master bus. I can also choose a different time span. So by default, Mixbus chooses the session and it gives me the time span in time code and also the length. I can choose to display that in minutes, seconds, or any other format. And I can also choose other time spans that have been defined, such as the loop, or if I've set up named time spans, those can show up in this list. I can also export multiples. So select all will export all of the defined time spans. We have another video that explains that in more detail. Now let's look at the most important features of the export dialog. You'll notice that the export dialog is set up with a tabbed interface. And each tab represents a format that we're going to export. So this particular tab is named CD plus MP3. I can add an additional format by clicking on this tab, switching to the new tab, and choosing another format. Now when I click the export button, both of these file formats will be created. We also have a preset mechanism, so I can create a preset. So I'll call this record label deliverables. and click New. And now, regardless of my settings, I can always return to my record label deliverables, and it recalls both of the formats that I've defined. I can also save and remove these presets using the buttons at the top. So let's investigate the features of an individual format tab. At the top of the tab, you'll see a format pull-down menu, and this has all my predefined formats for the files that I want to generate. I can create a new format by clicking the New button. I can remove this format, or I can edit the existing format. So let's first edit this format to view what's happening inside my CD plus MP3 format. You see I have a lot of selections available for the format. At the top of the dialog, I have the option to normalize my track. I also have the option of normalizing it to a peak value, in this case -1 dB full scale, or I can normalize the loudness using either LUFS or dB true peak, which is an interpolated peak value. So by normalizing the loudness, I can export multiple files and normalize them to the same loudness regardless of what their peak sample values are. Underneath the normalize option, I have an option to trim silence from the start. So if silence is detected at the introduction of the song, this will automatically trim the dead silence. I can choose to trim the silence at the end. So if there's any digital black at the end of my file, this will automatically truncate that off of the resulting export. In some cases, we are asked by our customer to add silence before and after each track. So we have an option to add silence, and I can add 1 second, for example, to the start of my exported file. And I could add silence to the end of the file. Below that, we'll find the details of the file format that we want to create. And there are some convenience features that help us choose suitable files. For example, if I want to be compatible with a CD uses linear PCM, WAVE, broadcast WAVE, or AIFF file formats, and it's always 44.1 kHz. A DVD is also lossless, same formats, but we have multiple sample rate selections. So the compatibility tab helps me choose sensible formatting choices. But I can also turn that off and select my formats manually. The quality list helps me to choose whether I want to use a lossy or a lossless format. Lossless is the high quality format, whereas lossy would be a compressed format like MP3 or another compression style. File format defines the file that we're creating, and this is how it will show up with the extension on your hard drive. So for example, we would most often choose WAVE, but we have other options like FLAC, which is a lossless compressed format. And then we have the sample rate. We can choose the session rate, which exports the file in the same rate that the session is already using, or we can have Mixbus resample the file to match a desired sample rate. Each file format has additional encoding options. For example, a WAVE file can be 16-bit, 24-bit, or 32-bit. And so we can choose those different formats here. And depending on our choice, we will have different choices appear for the dithering. If we're exporting a file to 16-bit, for example, then we are truncating off some of the bits during the export. So we need to add dither noise. Typically, we use shaped noise, but you can audition the other modes to see which one works best for you. Next, we have options to create a cue file, which is a file format that can be fed into a disk burning software, and it can name and sequence your tracks automatically. This works in conjunction with the named ranges. So when we set up CD ranges in Mixbus using the range tool, then those become track markers for CDs. We can create a cue file or a TOC, table of contents file, which is used by some other software. And we can also create chapter marker files, which can be imported into MP4 video creation tools. The label is the name that we create for this file format. Now, this is a CD format, so I've named it CD, and you'll see momentarily that I've also added an MP3 export mode. So I've named this my CD plus MP3 export format, and this is going to create a CD and MP3 output, all within the single format tab. At the very bottom, we find an advanced feature. This is a command line application that you can run after the export is completed. And you can use this to run your exported file through a file archiving utility, or a file conversion utility, or any other command line applications that you'd like to launch. You can launch scripts from here. You can arbitrarily define the arguments that will be fed to the command. So in this case, I'm using an MP3 converter called LAME, L-A-M-E, which is installed on my system. The minus sign B128 tells LAME to use a 128 kilobits bit rate for this MP3. And %F stands for the full path of this file. So I'm passing LAME the full file path of the resulting export file. I could also choose %D, which is the directory of the export file, and %B, which is the name of the file without the directory. And with those three special words, I can create all kinds of arbitrary archiving or file conversion utilities. So that explains all the features that are available in a single export format. I'm going to save my changes. We can also choose to click New and define our own brand new format. And in that case, I would want to name it using the label at the bottom. Now, once we've chosen the format that we want to make for the file, we now have to tell it where we would like the file to appear and what we would like the file to be named. By default, Mixbus will save your exported file in the same folder as your session folder in a subfolder called export. But I can navigate anywhere. For example, if I wanted to save the file to my desktop, I can click desktop, and now it would use the desktop as my export folder. But in this case, I want to save it into my radar demo session. Now that I've chosen the folder where I want the file to land, I need to tell it what I would like the file to be named. So we have quite a few options to help you name the file, and underneath you'll see a line that says current approximate file name, session.wav. So that file name was automatically generated by Mixbus based on the session name and the format that we're using. But I can modify that in any way I'd like. I could prepend the session name, radar demo, to my file name simply by clicking the name. Or I can make my own custom name. So this might be called, we'll call it Bridge Overdub. So now my file name says Bridge Overdub Session.wav. I can append a version number, R1. I can increment the revision number, so that it now says Bridge Overdub R3 Session.wav. By default, we append the time span name, because very often you've created multiple time spans. For example, if you're exporting a CD, and so it will use those time span markers to name each of the ranges as they're exported. In this case, I don't want that. I just want it to be called bridgeoverdub.wav. I can append the date, and I can tell it to append the time. And there are several formats for each of those. So as you can see, I can automatically build a fairly complicated export file, or I can just name it myself and override all the defaults. Let's export the file so we can see the final process. First, Mixbus plays through the session through the master bus. Then it normalizes and runs the post-export command. And you can see the result of the MP3 encoding down here at the bottom. I'll click on that to send it away. Now let's find the resulting files in Finder. So this is my session folder, and inside the export subfolder, we find two files, bridgeoverdub.mp3 and bridgeoverdub.wav. So we have the WAV file and the MP3 file, and I can audition those right inside Finder if I like. There are two other options that we've already investigated in other videos. One is the option to analyze the exported audio. That's a loudness analysis. And another option is to upload it to SoundCloud by entering your email and your password. Mixbus will automatically upload the resulting file directly to SoundCloud to your user account. As you can see, there are a tremendous number of options and incredibly powerful features here in Mixbus's export dialog. So I hope you'll enjoy investigating those features next time you're making an export.